Hello, today we are going to study two types of testing, that is automation testing and manual testing. Automation testing is nothing but when the user or when the developer take the help of automated tool, testing tools for software testing, then it is called as automation testing. Automation testing tool controls the execution of test and compares the actual results against the expected result. Generally, regression tests are automated tests. That means if we want to do regression tests, which are the repetitive actions, then these regression tests has to be automated. Now we will see what exactly regression testing is. So regression testing is a type of software testing to confirm that a recent program or code changes have not adversely affected the existing feature. Regression testing is nothing but a full or partial selection of already executed test cases, which are re-executed to ensure existing functionalities work fine. That means whenever we update the software or whenever we change to some software, then we have to confirm that after changing or after updating that software, there should not be adverse effect, or the software should not give you the wrong effect. That means many times it happens that if you change the particular part of the code, so that particular software may give you the wrong result in another section of the code. So regression testing is nothing but the retest of the test cases. So after changing the developer or after changing that particular code or that particular software, tester has to again check that software, so which is called as regression testing. Now automation testing means using an automation tools to execute your test case suite. On the contrary, manual testing is performed by human sitting in front of computer carefully executing test steps. That means in manual testing you have some automation testing tools available in your hand to test your software, but in manual testing every testing has been done by human being by sitting in front of the computer, and that human or that particular tester has to test your software by checking each and every step. So that is the difference between automation testing and manual testing. Now there are different phases of automation testing. Very first step is, or very first phase is, determining the scope of this test automation. Selecting the right tool for automation, you have to select the right tool for that particular software. That means if the software is designed in Java, you have to test that software by using the software tool which is compatible with Java. Third phase is you have to design the test plan. Then test design and test strategy has to be decided. Testing of the test environment, in which environment you are going to test your product, that you have to decide. Automation test script development and execution. And at last you have to analyze the test and generate the test reports. So many automated testing tools have some facilities which automatically generates the report whatever test you have done. In first of stage of automation testing, the feasibility is very much important. At every stage of automation testing, at every phase of automation testing, we have to remember the three things. The three things are which modules of the application can be automated and which are not, which tests can be automated and how to automate it. After determining which modules can be automated, we have to decide how that particular part or module can be automated. Then factors like cost, team size and expertise should also be considered. Whenever you select a software testing tool or any software testing application, then at that time you have to consider the factors like cost, what is the cost of that product, what is the team size of the testing, what is the testing team size, and how many expertise people in that testing software is available to you, so that your testing can be very much fruitful. Now JMeter is one of the automated testing tool which is 100% purely Java application designed to test the load and the performance of the web application. It was originally designed for testing the web application, but later it has been expanded and nowadays it can test many functions. So JMeter is the Apache JMeter application software for software testing. Now this JMeter has include some very some features, like it supports different application, its ability to load and performance test performance test many different applications, server protocols, protocol types, etc. So what things it can test? Web, that means HTTP, HTTPS, this protocol it can be test, its performance it can be test. Then SOAP and REST web services, FTP, database via JDBC, LDAP, message oriented middleware, mail, that is SMTP, POP3 and IMAP, native commands or shell script, TCP and Java objects. These are the features, or these are various applications which can be tested by JMeter. This JMeter have full featured IDE, that is integrated development environment, which is helpful for fast test planning recording. It has two modes, GUI mode and command line mode. This command line mode is used to test, load the test from any Java compatible operating system like Linux, Windows, Mac operating systems. A complete and ready to represent dynamic HTML report it can generate after testing. Complete portability and 100% Java purity. It can extract the data from various formats like HTML, JSON, XML or any textual format. It has multi-threading framework that allows the concurrent sampling by many threads, and simultaneously we can check or we can test various application at the same time. Now we will see the demonstration, a small demonstration of how this JMeter gives you the performance or calculate or test the load of the server. For that I have already created one test here whose name is graph result. Now this is the test plan. This test plan has considered it is divided into various thread groups. Now I have created two thread groups. First thread groups give you the performance of google.co.in server, and second group gives you the performance of yahoo.co.in server. So we will check the performance at this time of the Google server. Just after clicking on the graph result, you have to run the result, and after some time you will get the data or you will get the output of the server, which is of Google server. Now while calculating the performance or load of the server, you have to consider two terms. First term is throughput. Throughput is nothing but the ability of server to handle heavy load. How much heavy load that server can handle, it is the throughput. And deviation means deviation from the average value. And small value of deviation is better. Small value of deviation is better, and deviation is nothing but the deviation of average value. Now in this diagram, in this framework, you can see the red line, then green line, then pink line, blue line, and some black points are there. So this red line indicates the deviation, this green line indicates throughput, pink indicates medium, blue indicates average, and data is indicated by these black spots. So this is how your Google service or Google server is going to perform. Initially its throughput is very low, now its throughput is going to increase. So expected throughputs should be very high and deviation should be very less. So as per for ideal condition, throughput should be more and deviation should be very less from the average. So this deviation from the average should be very less. So this blue line and red line distance should be very less. So initially it was large, but now it is going to decrease here. So deviation is going to increase here and our throughput is going to increase here. So deviation, ये जो difference है दोनों का, blue और red का, उसको हम deviation बोलते हैं. So that deviation is now decreasing and this throughput is increasing gradually. So this is the performance of Google server. Now if I click on the graph result here in the another thread group, this is the performance of Yahoo server. This is the performance of Yahoo server. Now how to decide whether it is Google or Yahoo? So in HTTP request default, I have written here google.co.in. That means we are going to check the performance, we are going to test the performance of Google's server. And here in this thread group, I have set www.yahoo.com. So this has been this particular second thread group is given you the performance of Yahoo website. So these are the two websites. This is for Google and this is for Yahoo. This is for Google and this is for Yahoo. So this is how, by comparing various values like what is the throughput, what is the deviation, what are the average values, what are the median values, you can calculate the performance of your server. So here various options are there. So this is the demonstration how you can calculate or how can you can determine the load or performance of any web server by using JMeter. First of all, I have to stop it and then I can close it. So here today we have seen the what is the automation testing, what is manual testing, and JMeter is one of the software testing tool, and how to calculate, how to test the performance or how to test the load of the particular server. That demonstration we have seen.